Selfies, foodstagrams, babygrams, drinkstagrams. I'm an arsehole having a better holiday than you, stagrams. Photos like these are pretty much the lifeblood of the social web. But now, potentially, you can give your narcissism a brand new dimension. Seene is an app that wants to bring the third dimension to your phone, and just last week it was named the UK's most innovative mobile company by the Smart UK project. And quite simply, it lets you take photos in 3D. Now, the raw technology has been around for a while, but they're using the motion sensors in your phone. So you select a subject, usually the one with the most green points, good lighting helps, and then you just rotate around it and it maps it into a shape. Except when it doesn't and you get the stuff of childhood nightmares. The cool part is you can then experience the 3D on pretty much any device, be it a mobile or even a desktop. But the real question is, do you really need 3D foodstagrams and 3D selfies? Well, to answer that question and many more, will you please welcome our proving ground brain stars. He is the editor of Gizmodo Australia, Luke Hopewell. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me.
And she is the editor of techly.com.au, Claire Porter. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me.
Now, seriously, if you were Instagram, how badly do you wish you bought this?
So much. I feel like it's such a mistake that Instagram didn't capitalize on this when it first came out, because even the first edition of the app, some people are doing some really amazing things that really mess with your head. I feel like it would just be so much more successful than the video integration has been, because those videos never work anyway.
It is true that it certainly looks a lot better than most Instagram videos do, but tell me a little bit about why they decided to make everything about Seene completely resemble Instagram. What was the logic behind that?
The best way to get someone to use your new ecosystem, your brand new app that you don't have any community behind, is to make it look like something familiar. So for example, you don't want to make something completely foreign, completely alien to use, and really shut out your user base because they don't know how to get into your technology. You want something that actually feels like you've used it before, like you can say, oh, well, rather than this being a new app, it's instead a new feature.
Absolutely. And I think, as Luke was saying as well, making it look like the Instagram interface might be a subtle way to indicate to Instagram, it's like, hey, look how perfectly this would slot into your existing ecosystem.
So how actually is it to use? And when I say use, not just use, like, to get really good photos as well?
It's not just easy to use, it's really intuitive to use. It's something that actually lets you say, well, here's one point, here's another, and it's really fast as well.
All right, we're being all very lovey-dovey about it at the moment. I want to know, what doesn't work? What could it absolutely do better?
It tends to take things out of perspective. If you kind of, if you've got shaky hands like I tend to do, or you've focused on one area for too long, it kind of mutates the photo. So I took a photo of like a soft drink can, and then the can kind of looked like it was sort of stretched across the canvas of the photo. But even then I was like, yeah, creative.
Modernist 3D art. Anything you think they could do better?
It really needs to develop something which explodes it out and gets people coming back every day. That might be a bigger and better community. That might be a better way to explore photos. Some more gratification for really, really good scenes, for example.
Yeah, it's interesting because it's been around since kind of midway through like last year, and it haven't really seen a huge amount of take up. And that, why would you put that down to?
People need to come back because it's sticky. They need to come back to see how many likes they're getting, what their friends are doing, the crazy stuff that people are actually seeing. And it's just missing that. It really needs a bit more of that integration, a little more love.
All right, we're going to include a link to Seene on our Twitter feed. We are at the feed SBS2. Also tweet us, let us know if you have used it. And when you do take Seenes, send them to us. We are at the feed SBS2. Very big thank you to Luke Hopewell from Gizmodo. Thanks for coming back.
Thank you.
And Claire Porter from techly.com.au.
Thanks very much.
Right now, you are watching the feed here on SBS2.